नमः श्री यतिराजाय विवेकानंद सूरये सच्चित सुख स्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणे। डियर श्री पंड्या साहब, डियर श्री तड़वी साहब, द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ रामकृष्ण विवेकानंद सेंटर ऑफ अहमदाबाद, अदर डिग्निटीज प्रेजेंट हियर एंड रिस्पेक्टेड parents and dear friends, as you know, this program has been organized by Ramakrishna Mission in collaboration with AMA because we are celebrating the 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda. As I told you yesterday, I think some of you were there yesterday. How many of you there were there? Oh, almost all of you were there. How 50% of you were there. Very good. And how many of you are parents? Oh, most of them are parents. That's good. So, as I told yesterday, 50% of you know that we wanted Swami Vivekananda's 150th birth anniversary to be between 2013 to 14, since Swami Vivekananda was born on 12 January 1863. But it turned out to be that the Central Committee, consisting of the then Prime Minister of India and other 9 chief ministers and other dignitaries, they decided that Swami Vivekananda's message is so very relevant and so very important that we should, some of the programs should start, like value education programs, should start from 2010 itself. And we wanted to give a break in 2014. In fact, we had concluding celebrations in the month of January at our headquarters, Belur Math. But some of the programs took time to end up because of various reasons. So this program is being conducted as a part of 150th birth anniversary. And in all probability, we'll be ending up by 2015, January. We hope that everything will be over. So it has become a 5-year plan. We wanted only 1 year. So this is the first time in the world history that Swami Vivekananda's 150th birth anniversary, that any great person's 150th birth anniversary is celebrated for 5 years. Now, why we have chosen this topic, effective parenting? Parenting is a must. But over a period of time, parenting is becoming more and more ineffective, more and more difficult because of various reasons. Some time back, the parents used to tell me, nowadays our children do not pay proper respect. We used to do pranam to our parents, but the children are not paying proper respect. That was long back. Then came a time when the parents started telling, aajkal na chokra koi sambhalta nahi, the children do not listen to us, they are most disobedient. And now the latest statement of the parents is, we are afraid of our children. Previously, the children used to be afraid of parents. We were afraid of our parents, especially father, if supposing we do something and there will be a scolding. Sometimes methi pak pan mare kadach. Pan have to undu che. The parents are under stress ki kyarek kadach modhamathi ke bolai gyo na pelo suicide kar liye, hanging kar liye, to apne police ma javu pade, jail ma javu pade. Kai kevata nathi, na kidha vagar je emne kharab lage che to kidha thi to pachi su thai jaye. So it is becoming a very, very difficult task because I am in touch with the parents. And those children who are not obeying you, who are so sensitive, so egoistic, these children, they are my friends. They come to me in the evening. Morning, my parents have told, you have told me your problem. In the evening, these children come to me. They are my friends. What do they say? Amne gharma koi samatu nathi, samajma maktu pan nathi. Nobody understands me at home, and nobody wants to understand me also. That is the height of tragedy. So they have their own problems. They have got their peer pressure. They have got their own problems. So, where is the meeting point? How to make parenting effective? And what exactly is parenting? Particularly, I'll be talking in Indian context. We are in India. Had I given this talk in America, I would have taken the topic in a very different manner. Because there, of course, you have many problems. But I tell the children that you have better prospects of getting concentration of mind and penetrating mind. Why? Because you have got purity. Why? Because you have one father and one mother. Which is not the situation in America. Which is not the situation in America. Now, 70% of the children in some places are having single parent. Single parent has become a very difficult problem. And most of the time, single parent means mother. Because single father doesn't take the child, he just puts it into the orphanage, him or her into the orphanage. Or there are so many other things. Just as old age homes are coming up, in America it is an old concept, in India it is coming up. There it is the child care centers that are coming up, where the children will go. Because after marriage, hardly 2 or 3 years, the divorce takes place on an average. I went to America 2010. Last year I went, but that time I did not have interaction. But 2010 when I went, so many parents, they came and told me the situation. What is the problem? Problem is that my son, he has taken up my business. Everything is going fine. But only one problem. He is 40 years old and he says, I don't want to marry. Another person says, my daughter, getting good package, weekend she comes to our house and to say hello. Only problem, 40 years age, she says, I don't want to marry. Then I ask the children, why don't you want to marry? We don't want to burn our fingers. What? Marrying means burning fingers? Yes. Our friends have married and most of them have burned their fingers. That is, after 2 or 3 years, they have got divorce. And the cost of divorce is more than the cost of marriage in America. Not in India. India, the cost of marriage is more. But they are the advocates, because divorce means you have to go through the lawyers. And lawyers, they are taking fees in millions of dollars or thousands of dollars. It is, you cannot imagine that astronomic figure. So they said, if you have to get divorce after 2 or 3 years, and the cost of divorce is much more than the marriage, why should you marry? After all, the animals are not marrying. So become animals. And after divorce, what happens to the children? Go to the child care unit or orphanage. So the situation in other countries, Western countries, is much different from India. I am talking in Indian context, where there is one father and one mother in most of the houses, where the divorce has not taken place, actually. Virtually it has taken place. Abola che. Pati patni vache. I remember a joke. Husband wife vache abola hata. So the husband told the wife. Now he cannot tell anything. So he gave a slip of paper. Tomorrow I have to catch a flight at 6 o'clock. So please get me at 4 o'clock. So next day he found, as usual, he got up 8 o'clock and the flight he has missed, and he was so angry. He immediately wrote a slip of paper. Why didn't you get up? Get me up at 4 o'clock, I had told you. Again, the wife wrote in a slip of paper, please see the slip below your pillow. Exactly at 4 o'clock I placed the slip. That now get up. Because abola chhe na. So more or less this situation, but at least divorce has not taken place. The children are under one umbrella, in one family. The family is not disintegrated. Yes, of course it is a nuclear family. Parents of the parents are not there. In our times, our dada dadi, our grandfather, grandma, they used to give practical wisdom, because both of them will be very busy. It is the grandparents, they used to give value education, they used to give the stories, but the grandparents are in old age home. So whenever somebody wants to reserve seats for old age home for his parents, I say, don't reserve two seats, reserve four seats. Because your children are watching you and they will put you into old age home much earlier, before your retirement. Because always remember, values are never taught, values are always caught. Whatever you do, that will be done by children. They are like monkeys. You tell them, take out the cap, they will not. If you throw the cap, they will throw the cap. So if you put your parents into the old age home, your children are ready to put you into old age home much earlier. So parenting has become difficult, for the reason is that parents themselves have become prey of the present scenario. So why it is difficult? Number one, generation gap. Alvin Toffler said, he wrote a book, The Future Shock, and there he wrote, the society is undergoing transformation at such an accelerated speed that the society would not be able to absorb that shock. That time has come. It is such a great speed with which the society is undergoing transformation that the shock is coming. I am here in Baroda for 9 years, as you know. The historic Dilaram Bungalow, in which Swami Vivekananda himself stayed as the guest of the then Diwan Manibhai Jasbhai in 1892, was handed over by the government of Gujarat to Ramakrishna Mission for converting into a befitting memorial of Swami Vivekananda. And so, on 18th April 2005, the new center of Ramakrishna started in Gujarat. Now we have four centers in Gujarat: Rajkot, Limdi, Porbandar, and Vadodara. Porbandar also, the historic Bhojeshwar Bungalow where Swami Vivekananda stayed, was handed over by the government of Gujarat on 12 January 1997. Limdi, the palace, was handed over by the Rajmata, and Rajkot center is more than 90 years old. So these are the four centers in Gujarat. There are 178 centers all over the world, 40 abroad, rest in India, with the headquarters at Belur Math. So I am in this Baroda center for 9 years. Before that, I was in Porbandar for 8 years, and before that, I was in Rajkot, as you just now heard, editing the Gujarati Monthly. At that time, many youngsters used to come. Afterwards, my life became more mobile and I had to go all over the country or sometimes abroad. But in Rajkot, I was concentrating more on the youth movement. That time, one girl used to come to me. She was studying in MSc Microbiology, very smart girl. She used to give speeches. We used to conduct competitions for students as a part of Swami Vivekananda birthday celebration. She used to participate, and every time she will get the first prize. She will get the medal. And she used to give big speeches on generation gap. Nowadays, parents do not understand the children. There is a generation gap. After 2 years, she passed MSc Microbiology and became lecturer in that very college where she was studying. After 2 years, she came to me, Swamiji, I used to give B lectures on generation gap. Now my students are telling, madam, you are too old. There is a generation gap. You will not understand us. Within 5 years, there is a generation gap. Previously, generation gap used to come after 100 years, then 50 years. Now, within 5 years, the whole generation is changing. The same times are changing. The whole values are changing. Every day, new mobile. Every day, new design of mobile. Every day, new mobile, new car design. Every day, new thing. So many electronic gadgets everywhere, internet, WhatsApp, Facebook, social media. So many changes taking place. The generation gap is coming. Those who used to tell that, oh, I am in Facebook. Well, what? You are older. We are in WhatsApp. you are much older generation. So generation gap. The generation gap is coming at a great speed. So that is one reason because of which parenting has become difficult. Because so much of generation gap, the parents are not able to understand the children. Children think we do not understand, they do not understand us. And parents, they are bewildered by the behavior. Second is a demon has entered into our family, has entered in our society, in every house. And the name of that demon is consumerism. Oxford Dictionary has added one more word recently. The name of the word is affluenza, not influenza. Influenza we sometimes get also. But this is affluenza, it comes to affluent people. And in America, they have started, the parents in America have started affluenza resistant society in order to protect their children from the effect of affluenza. What is affluenza? Affluenza comes to affluent people, the children of the affluent people. What do? Every day they want more and more gadgets, more latest model gadgets, 10 shoes, they want 11 shoes, 3 mobiles, 4 mobiles, 2 cars, 3 cars, more. And the more they get, more dissatisfied they are becoming. They are competing with others and they are becoming dissatisfied, ultimately becoming prey of Nugent neurosis, then drug addiction, and then psychic patient, and then suicide. So, in order to protect the children from this effect of affluenza, the parents are taking the children at the weekend to the village side and telling, you see the children here do not have even one car and you are having 2 cars and still you are feeling dissatisfied. Showing them simple way of life and also telling them and cutting their pocket expenditure. So this is one thing. Of course, in India, only 10% people are affluent. So affluence has not come in a big way. But consumerism has come. The previous formula, principle for all of us was simple living, high thinking. Now the formula is high living, simple thinking, and sometimes no thinking. Nobody knows what is the purpose of life. You ask anybody, everybody is going mad after money, so I am going mad after money. Everybody going mad after career development package, I am also going after that. But where are we going? What is the purpose of life? No time, because the car is going at such a great speed. There is no time to ask where are you going. You start from Ahmedabad, go to Surat, and then you come to know you have to go to Rajkot, so come back. And the person who goes by slow speed, direction is okay, that person will reach Rajkot much earlier. So we are bothering about speed, but we are not bothering about direction. That is the paradox. There is a Zen story. A horse was galloping at full speed. And somebody asked the person who was sitting on the horse, where are you going? The person replied, ask the horse. Because I am not taking the horse, horse is taking me. So we are not leading the life, life is leading us. We are going blind like a flock of sheep, one after another. We have lost our moorings, we have lost our this purpose of life. So consumerism come in a big way. Eric Fromm wrote a beautiful book, To Have or To Be, in which he says, man has become a commodity, he thinks himself like a commodity, and sells himself like a commodity. Yes, you know, in Bihar, in UP, the bridegrooms are sold. Engineer, 40 lakhs, doctor, 60 lakhs, bribery, this dowry. And if your bridegroom is, if your son is an IAS officer, then you will get dowry of 1 crore. I don't know the latest rate. This is, I'm telling about 3-4 years back. So the bridegrooms are being sold. They are being sold. So man has become a commodity. He thinks himself like a commodity and sells himself like a commodity. So we have lost the purpose of life. Dana Zuhas, she has written a beautiful book. The name of the book is SQ, Spiritual Intelligence, the Ultimate Intelligence, where she says neurologically, physiologically, biologically, psychologically, from every point of view, there is a concluding evidence. There is something called SQ, which is the basis of both IQ and EQ. What is IQ? Intelligence quotient. IQ will tell you how to play the game of life. What is EQ? Emotional quotient. EQ will tell you how to play the game of life under changed circumstances with changed strategies. And what is SQ? SQ will tell you whether to play the game of life at all or not. Well, that is your choice. What is the purpose of life? What is the meaning of life? And then Dana Zohar says, IQ is available with all the species, including the computers. EQ is available only with the human species. EQ is available only a few species. And SQ is available only with the human species. Our scriptures used to say, out of 84 lakhs of species, only human beings have got spiritual quotient. Now, the modern sciences know there are 125 lakhs of yonis, the species, out of which only human species have got SQ. So both are telling the same thing, only little difference. Maybe at that time cloning was not going on. So less of species. But not much different. 84 lakhs, 125 lakh, according to modern science. But both are telling only human beings have got SQ, have got the potentiality to have spiritual perfection in life. That is the purpose. But we have forgotten that purpose. She gives a beautiful example. By the side of the Mexican coast, there was a management consultant sitting there. And he saw, just by the side, on the seashore, there was a boat. And a fisherman was sleeping on the boat. And it was afternoon. So that management consultant said, "Hey, what is this? Why are you not fishing? It is still afternoon. Why are you sleeping?" Then, while sleeping posture, he replied, "You see what happened, sir. In the morning, I got a very big catch. And so I sold that fish and got a lot of money. That is enough for my today's needs. So my quota is over. And so I am relaxing." "What? Is there any quota in earning money? You should earn more." "But what will I do with excess money?" "Why? Deposit." He had never heard the deposit. "Yes, deposit. Then go on depositing. When you get more money, then you purchase one more boat. Then you will get more fishes, more money. Then again deposit. Then again boat, another boat. Likewise, you go on multiplying boats. Then you will become a CEO of a multinational company, having your branches in New York, London, and all that. Then when you've got so many branches, you'll have to go abroad, you have to manage the whole affairs. Naturally, your blood pressure will increase, you will have bypass surgery. When we have 3 bypass surgeries, when the doctor says enough of enough, then you come back to me, sell all these things, all the branches, and bring the money to me. I am the investment expert of Harvard University. So I know the latest market rate of every company. I will tell you where to invest and how to invest. When you invest like this, every month you will get a fixed income and you will be able to sleep nicely." "I was sleeping nicely, it is you woke me up." "For sleeping nicely, such a big chakkar, such a big roundabout process." This is the thing. Dana Zohar says in that book, this fisherman has low IQ. He doesn't know how to make money. Whereas this management expert from Harvard, he has got high IQ. He knows how to make money. But this fisherman has got high SQ. He knows what is the purpose of life, is to have happiness and peace. And this fellow has got low SQ or no SQ. So we must have. This is what has happened. That most of the people do not have SQ in the modern society. We have become prey of affluenza and consumerism. And we have all of have got an equation called H is directly proportional to M, where H is equal to happiness and M is equal to money. The more money we will get, the more happiness we will get. But do we get it? Do we get it? You just have introspection. Can money buy everything? मेनी पीपल से, स्वामी जी आप नहीं समझेंगे, आप साधु हैं आप क्या समझेंगे, अरे पैसा आएगा हम लेटेस्ट मॉडल की कार ले लेंगे, लेटेस्ट मॉडल का पैसा ले, लेटेस्ट मॉडल का ड्रेस ले लेंगे, लेटेस्ट मॉडल का मोबाइल ले लेंगे, अरे पैसा होगा तो भगवान को भी खरीद लेंगे। हाँ हाँ, वो पुजारी को 100 रुपए का नोट दिखाएंगे तो हमको बैक डोर से स्पेशल दर्शन करा करके 56 भोग का प्रसाद दे देगा। क्या बात करते हैं, पैसा होने से भगवान को भी खरीद लेते हैं। मतलब भाई बहुत अच्छा है भाई, बहुत पैसा कमाओ, पर एक बात बताता हूं, पैसे से सब कुछ खरीदा जा सकता है बट मन की शांति नहीं खरीदी जा सकती है। यू कैन नॉट परचेज अ स्मॉल पैकेट ऑफ पीस ऑफ माइंड फ्रॉम एनी मेडिकल स्टोर बाय एनी नंबर ऑफ मनी बाय एनी अमाउंट ऑफ मनी। यदि ऐसा होता, इफ हैड इट बीन देयर देन इन द वर्ल्ड सो मच सो मेनी रिच पीपल वुड नॉट बी सो अनहैप्पी। देयर आर 3 countries इन द होल वर्ल्ड हैविंग हाईएस्ट पर कैपिटा इनकम, अमेरिका, जापान एंड स्वीडन, एंड 3 companies हैविंग हाईएस्ट रेट ऑफ सुसाइड्स, इंक्रीजिंग रेट ऑफ सुसाइड। What are the countries? America, Japan and Sweden. And 3 countries having highest rate of increasing number of psychic patients. What are the countries? America, Japan and Sweden. So what is the equation? H is inversely proportional to M. Wherever there is more per capita income, those people are suffering more. Otherwise, why should we? If they are not suffering, why should they commit suicide? Why should they go to mental hospital? In America, when new book has come, the name of the book is The Final Exit by Derek Humphries, and the book is also Exit, not available. Selling like hotcake. After long search, I found one book in the bookshop, in the book fair. I wanted to know what is written there. Do you know what is written there? How to commit suicide. Various measures have been given and the book is selling like hotcake. The Final Exit by Derek Humphries. And he has called a society also called Final Exit. People can become members of Final Exit and can find out ways and means how to commit suicide. A new book has come out in Japan. The name of the book is The Complete Manual on Committing Suicide. And the book is selling like hotcake, 3.5 lakhs copies sold in 1 year, and some people committed suicide taking the book in their hand. The bestseller book name of France is Suicide User's Manual. So they all want to commit suicide. We fill so-called developed countries with high per capita income would be very happy. In fact, long back, it is not recent, but sometime back, I just glanced through some news item. They had a happiness survey. Which are the countries having high happiness? Happiness survey they carried out, and they found out there is one country where the people are happiest. What is the country name? Bangladesh. Having lowest per capita income. So H is directly proportional to M. Our equation is wrong. And that is why this consumerism is taking a toll. We feel if money comes, all our problems will be solved. But don't take a wrong message. Money is very, very, very important. Economic development is a must for a developing country like ours. But money cannot solve all the problems of life, and money cannot be the ultimate aim of life. Money can be a medium of getting happiness. Money itself cannot give us happiness. That we have to remember. It can give roti, kapda, makan. That's all. After roti, kapda, makan, the psychologists have carried a survey. Till roti, kapda, makan has been achieved, the happiness graph goes up. It is hyperbola. And once after roti, kapda, makan, it goes down. Roti, kapda, makan ke baad, ek gaadi mein, bahut happiness hui. Do gaadi aane se, happiness kam hoti hai. 10 gaadi aane se, usko maintenance mein itna problem hota hai ki happiness bahut zero aa jati hai. The more cars, more unhappiness. But one car, happiness increases. 2 cars, little less. I'm giving an example similarly with everything. So, this is one reason why parenting is becoming difficult in the present scenario. Third is media. Both print media and electronic media is playing a vital part. The media has also entered into our houses and creating problems in our relationships. In parenting is becoming difficult. In America, the third generation of TV viewers is going on. Now, at present, most of the parents are... Previously, the parents used to complain, Sara din TV dekhta rehta hai, bachcha. Abhi wo gaya, TV gaya. Video game. Internet, cheating, chatting, going together. Internet. WhatsApp. फेसबुक ये सब आ गया. नाउ द पेरेंट्स डू नॉट नो वेदर वी शुड गिव मोबाइल भी. अब ना प्रीवियसली दे हैड ए प्रॉब्लम वेदर टू गिव मोबाइल और नॉट. मोबाइल नहीं देने से तो आउटडेट हो जाएंगे. सो चिल्ड्रन को मोबाइल तो देना पड़ेगा. नाउ चिल्ड्रन चाहते हैं हम मोबाइल से हमको पेट नहीं भरने का, हमको स्मार्टफोन चाहिए, उसमें व्हाट्सएप होना चाहिए, उसमें इंटरनेट होना चाहिए, नहीं तो भूख हड़ताल. सो द मीडिया इज प्लेइंग ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन चेंजिंग द सिनेरियो. एट प्रेजेंट इन अमेरिका द थर्ड जनरेशन ऑफ टीवी व्यूअर्स इज गोइंग ऑन. अवर्स इज ओनली सेकेंड जनरेशन बट देयर थर्ड जनरेशन व्यू पेरेंट्स आर हैविंग आर थर्ड जनरेशन टीवी व्यूअर्स. सो दे कैरिड आउट ए सर्वे ऑन थर्ड जनरेशन पेरेंट्स. दे कैरिड आउट ए सर्वे एंड फाउंड आउट दैट द चिल्ड्रन हु आर बॉर्न टू द पीपल हु आर सीइंग टीवी फ्रॉम थ्री जनरेशंस एंड देयर एवरेज नंबर ऑफ आवर्स इज 6 hours कंपेयर टू 3 hours ऑफ इंडिया. सो दोज हु आर सीइंग मोर देन 6 hours ऑफ टीवी their parents and their parents, this third generation, when their children are born with very, very strong optical nerve. That means they will be able to see TV more. Born with high optical nerve, very strong optical nerve. And analytical nerve is missing, not there. Because we don't have to do analysis in TV. So the third generation, the parents, the children of the third generation parents, they do not have analytical nerve, and that is why they gave the name idiot box. Now they are throwing that idiot box, and we are bringing in our homes idiot box. Many children, they have come to know the massacre that is being done by the idiot box. Leave apart the other things, by the age of 14 years an American boy or girl by the age of 14 years watches TV in which minimum 1 lakh murders. And so naturally he becomes a murderer. He also wants to try a gun. 74% of the people in America are having guns. Why I am saying all these things? Comparatively, you are thinking that parenting is very difficult. It is very difficult, very, very difficult. But compared to other countries, in India, we are still at a better. Of course, those values are very fast receding because of the media. We are becoming westernized. But as long as still we have got some values, Indian values in our families, as long as they are there, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, these values are there. Till that time, still something is surviving. And if we are not careful, much before we expect, we will be wiped out. So I have come here to give a red light signal to you. Better let us take this precaution, otherwise it will be too late. On an emergency scale, we have to take up value education programs. Otherwise, both at the house level, at the school level, we are telling that if the value education does not come, if the Indian family values do not come back, are not practiced, we are going to be facing the same problems that are being faced by the parents in America or Western countries. In Bengali, there is a proverb, Keu dekhe shikhe, keu theke shikhe, keu theke na shikhe. Some people learn by others' experience. Some people learn by their own experience. Nahi, wahan gadda hai. Bhai, wahan gadda hai, humko nahi jana hai. दूसरों को देख करके सीखते हैं. बट सम पीपल से अच्छा थोड़ा गिर के देखें तो गड्ढे में कैसा लगता है, तो गिरते हैं. गिरने पर भाई अब नहीं जाएंगे, ठोकर खा लिया, अब उस रास्ते से नहीं जाना है. और कितने लोग इतने इंटेलिजेंट होते हैं, बार बार ठोकर खाते हैं, बार बार उसी रास्ते से जाते हैं. लेट अस नाउ एनालाइज व्हाट टाइप ऑफ पीपल वी आर, फर्स्ट सेकेंड और थर्ड कैटेगरी. यंगस्टर्स तो बोलते हैं हमको सेकंड कैटेगरी, हमको फर्स्ट कैटेगरी नहीं चाहिए, हम तो गिरना ही चाहते हैं प्रेम रूपी कुएं में गिर करके, फिर उसके बाद में आपको बताएंगे कितना लगता है, फिर बाद में सुसाइड का आइडिया लेकर के फिर काउंसलिंग ले आएंगे, पर अभी तो हमको गिरने दो. वी वॉन्ट टू एक्सपेरिमेंट इन हाउ टू फॉल डाउन. तो एनी वे दिस चॉइस इज अवर्स. वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज पेरेंट्स आर सफरिंग लाइक दिस. डू वी वॉन्ट द सेम पोजिशन इन इंडिया? इफ नॉट, and on an emergency basis, we have to start practicing Indian spiritual, cultural values in our homes. Otherwise, it will be too late. I am giving you a warning. It will be too late if we do not do it on an emergency scale. Of course, there is more problem. There are so many other problems. I will not go for that. Commercialization of education is also one reason because of which these schools and colleges are not able to give value education, importance of value education. They leave it to the parents, and the parents themselves are so busy that they also and they themselves are prey. 12th class science mein ek ladka tha. One boy was in 12th science. So parents are telling, hey, 12th science, your whole future is there. 12th science means Pakistan se yuddh ho raha hai ekdam. Whole house is in tension. Not only the boy. Their parents are more under tension than the boy. And they are telling, no, 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 you should not watch TV, this and that. Then he says, oh, tum log watch karte ho, main kyun nahi watch karunga? So then the father told, you see, you are watching this TV, Saas Bahu, ye sab serial dekhti rehti ho, uski bahut kharab effect hoti hai. To tum usko band karo. To usne kaha, theek hai, main band karungi, tum tumhara cricket match wagera sab band karo. फिर दोनों ने सेट किया कि चलो भाई वो टीवी को बांध करके ऊपर रख दो. बट दैट इज वेरी रेयर. नॉर्मली एवरीथिंग गोज ऑन एंड वी गो ऑन ब्लेमिंग द चिल्ड्रन. बट वी आवरसेल्व्स आर प्रे टू द मीडिया. हाउ कैन वी प्रोटेक्ट अवर चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम द मीडिया? सो दीज आर ऑल वेरी वेरियस प्रॉब्लम्स. बट वन थिंग इज देयर दैट इफ वी रियली वॉन्ट टू provide values to our children, we will have to practice them ourselves. This is most important. Because values are never taught, values are always caught. I remember a joke. One person was going in the train along with his child. Now the railway station came. Papa, papa, ice cream le do. अरे अभी अभी खा के निकला घर से, आइसक्रीम चाहिए. नहीं ले दोगे तो बता दूंगा. तो उसको आइसक्रीम ले दिया. आफ्टर सम टाइम अनदर स्टेशन, भेलपुरी भेलपुरी भेलपुरी. पापा भेलपुरी ले दो. अरे अभी आइसक्रीम खाए उसके बाद भेलपुरी खाते हैं? बता दूंगा. फिर से भेलपुरी ले दिया. अनदर स्टेशन खिलौना है, खिलौना. पापा पापा खिलौना. अरे इतना खर्चा करा दिया, अभी खिलौना चाहिए? बता दूंगा. फिर खिलौना दे दिया. बाजू में एक बैठा था, क्या है तुम, कैसे फादर हो? व्हाट टाइप ऑफ फादर यू आर? एक छोटा सा बच्चा तुमको एक्सप्लॉइट कर रहा है, एक लाइक ए टेररिस्ट, आतंकवादी के समान तुमको इस प्रकार से परेशान कर रहा है, और तुम सब उसका मान रहे हो. बोले, गलती मेरी है, आधी टिकट लिया. टीटी को बोले, मैं टीटी को बता दूंगा मेरी एज क्या है. तो this is what happens. Ultimately, if you follow the values, if you follow, sometimes they say honesty is a best good policy. Honesty is the best policy. No, honesty is the only policy. If you really want to have profit in the long term, ultimately dishonesty does not pay. That father discovered, ye honesty kiya rehta, to इतना खर्चा नहीं होता, हाफ टिकट ही जाता. एंड आई वुड हैव पूरी जर्नी भी तो शांति रहती. ये तो पूरी जर्नी में उसको टेंशन होता है, कहीं बोल देगा तो एज, पकड़ा जाऊंगा तो. होल जर्नी टेंशन में चली गई. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, इफ यू फॉलो द वैल्यूज, द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट कम्स टू यू दैट यू आर हैविंग पीस ऑफ माइंड. दैट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट कम्स. दोज हू फॉलो वैल्यूज, दे आर हैविंग पीस ऑफ माइंड, विच इज वेरी मच अर्जेंटली रिक्वायर्ड. सो वी विल कम टू दैट थिंग afterwards. But most of the people, all the great people, they are born, they owe their greatness to their parents. Whether it is Jijabai, Shivaji, whether it is Swami Vivekananda, whether it is Mahatma Gandhi, who was given 3 teachings before going to abroad. She took 3 promises, and as you know, that's how he could practice those values. So any great person in the history, if you see, the credit goes to the parents. Now that we are observing 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekananda, just imagine when the people die, their last obituary note is the last news item, isn't it? For most of the people. But Swami Vivekananda gave up his body on 4 July 1902. He was very popular. On 11th September 1893, he gave his historic speech, and all the newspapers were flooded with that news item. From that day, he became popular. He was quite popular on 11th September 1893. He was much more popular when he left his body on 4 July 1902. And when his centenary celebrations were going on, one of the greatest historians of our times, A.L. Basham, said about him, "It is very difficult to evaluate the importance of Swami Vivekananda in the scale of history because we are too near the history. Perhaps the future generations will be able to understand his greatness better." And after 150 years also, we can tell the same thing. The centenary celebrations were grand, but 150th birthday celebration 10 times grander. And I'm sure we will not be, maybe may not be alive, excepting few young friends. But 200th celebration will be much more grander. We can assure that. Why? Because he is a global leader for a global civilization for all times. He practiced values in his life. But how these values came, how he became great, because of his parents. Once he asked his father when he was a child, "Father, what you have given me, what you have left for me, you are giving everything to other people." Because his father was very large-hearted, he would give so many things to so many people. "What you have kept for me, what you have given me, what share you are giving me?" The young Narendra asked, let future Swami Vivekananda, the young Narendra, when he was in school boy, he asked his father. Father said, "Go, look into the mirror and you will find out what I have given you." That is a wonderful body with a great psychic control. That's personality of Swami Vivekananda. That was the granting by the father. And values were given by mother. So Swami Vivekananda says about his mother in America, when he was talking to women, then he was talking on women of India. There he told, in India, the women are primarily mothers. They think their culmination is in motherhood. And then he told about his own experience. For the first time, he shared his own personal experience. Though he was a monk, though he had left his parents, but yet he had that reverence for the parents. He says about, Swamiji says about his mother, Bhuvaneshwari Devi, "Always suffering, always loving, the love which my mother gave to me has made me what I am, and I owe a debt to her that I can never repay. I know that before I was born, my mother would fast and pray and do hundreds of things which I could not even do for 5 minutes. She did that for 2 years. I believe that whatever religious culture I have, I owe to that. It was consciously that my mother brought me into the world to be what I am. Whatever little good impulse I have was given to me by my mother, and consciously, not unconsciously. It is the mother who imparts those spiritual values, cultural values, into the children." And then Swamiji says about the role of a mother. "From motherhood comes tremendous responsibility. There is the basis. Start from that. Well, why is mother to be worshipped so much? Because our books teach us that it is the prenatal influence that gives the impetus to the child for good or evil." This is our Indian concept. One mother took her child to Socrates and asked her, "At what age should I start educating my child?" And Socrates asked, "What is the age of this child?" She said, "It is 5 years." Socrates said, "You come 5 years late because the education starts from day one." But that is Western concept. Indian concept is education starts from -6 months. When the child is in the womb, and that is why Gujarat government has started Children University. The children have to be given training when they are not yet born. And so there is Tapovan that has been created for pregnant mothers, where they will be staying in that pure atmosphere. Because most of the values, or many values, ingrained values in the psyche, comes when a child is in the womb. The type of programs that a pregnant mother watches, the type of thoughts that a pregnant mother has got, all these have got great effect on the children who are in the womb. So Swami Vivekananda says, because our books teach us that it is the prenatal influence that gives the impetus to the child for good or evil. Go to 100,000 colleges, read 1,000,000 books, associate with all the learned men of the world, better off you are when born with the right stamp. So if you are born with the right stamp, even one book will give you values. If you are not born with right stamp, when your mother was pregnant, no amount of books can give you that knowledge. Thus say our books direct the prenatal influence. Why should mother be worshipped? Because she made herself pure. She underwent harsh penances sometimes to keep herself as pure as purity can be. My father and mother fasted and prayed for years and years so that I would be born. They pray for every child before it is born. Says our great lawgiver Manu, giving the definition of an Aryan. He is the Aryan who is born through prayer. A child who is born without prayer will be always a curse to the society, will be criminal to the society. She was a saint to bring me into the world. She kept her body pure, her food pure, her clothes pure, her imagination pure for years because I would be born. Because she did that, she deserves worship. So that is why we start with Matru Devo Bhava, not Pitru Devo Bhava. First is Matru Devo Bhava. It is the mother who carries the womb who carries the child in the womb. Then Pitru Devo Bhava. Then Acharya Devo Bhava. And then Atithi Devo Bhava. And then all other gods. So Matru Devo Bhava, why? Because it is the mother preeminently responsible. So this is our Indian spiritual culture. Family values are fast degrading. Even now, today, there are some family values, but very fast they are disappearing. And the Western influence is coming. Swami Vivekananda said, what we want is Western science coupled with Vedanta. He was not a closed mind. He said, yes, we want the best of the East and West. But best of West we must take, not the worst of West. He said, we should not have blind imitation of Western materialistic culture. We must take good values also from the Western society. But good values, not the bad values, not the values for which, bad values for which they are suffering and they are committing suicide and they are taking psychic patients. Let us not import that materialistic, Western materialistic culture. Import that one and let our children also go to the same process of becoming psychic patients and also going towards suicide. So, we have to finish this first session very quickly and then we will have a tea break, and then in the second session we will have Arunima Sinha, who will tell how she became great. Any great personality, always the credit goes to the parents. How she was groomed by her parents, always the secret of success of any great personality is because of the parents. So parenting is a very, very responsible thing, and that is why we are now talking about effective parenting. If parenting becomes effective, automatically the children will be great, and when the children are great, they will become enlightened citizens. When they are enlightened citizens, then the nation will become great. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam came on 12 January 2006 to inaugurate the Vivekananda Institute of Value Education Culture, Vivek. That was the Swami's birthday. There were 5,000 youths, so he first told how Swami Vivekananda inspired Jamsetji Tata to start Indian Institute of Science while they were traveling together in the same ship from Japan to Chicago. And then There was a question and answer session. One boy stood up and said, "Sir, Operation Duryodhan, Operation Chakravyuh, Operation Chakravyuh and other operations have revealed the tip of the iceberg, that is rampant corruption in the country today. As the President of India, how do you feel about it? And where do you think lies the solution?" Then he got up and said, "You see, the parliament has already taken some action on the MPs." And then he took out a book of Swami Vivekananda and read out one passage from the book of Swami Vivekananda, in which he said, Swami Vivekananda says, "No number of parliament acts can make a nation good, can make a nation great." Then what can make a nation good and what can make a nation great? Again, he read out from Swami Vivekananda's book, said, "Only a large number of good, enlightened citizens, good people, can make a nation good and can make a nation great." And then he said, "And the government cannot produce good people, and the government will not produce good people." That also he said. Then who can do it? Only three persons can do it. Who are the three? Father, mother, and the teacher. Nobody else can do it. Only father, mother, and the teacher. The Prime Minister of India cannot do anything for national development. Mind you, whosoever he may be, whosoever he is, he may have any amount of charisma. He cannot do anything. Any best of the best Prime Minister also cannot do anything. Ministers cannot do it. IAS officers cannot do it. IAS officer cannot do it. Cannot make India great. Only three persons can make India great. Only three persons can fulfill the dream of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda said, "India will become so great that its past glory will fade into insignificance. It will become so great, not only economically, in all aspects. India shall conquer the whole world by its spiritual culture." If you are to fulfill this dream of Swami Vivekananda, in that case, India has to become great. India cannot become great by any number of ministers, IAS officers. Only three persons can make India great, can fulfill the dream of Swami Vivekananda. Dr. Kalam said, who are the three? Father, mother, and the teacher. And really speaking, then one girl said, "What I, as a small child, can contribute towards making India great and removing the corruption of the country? How can I remove corruption? Because the whole thing is now, basic problem is corruption. So how can I remove corruption as a small child? What can be my contribution in removing corruption? Because I am not IAS officer. I am not IPS officer. I am not a minister. How can I remove corruption from my country?" Dr. Kalam said, "You can do it. You can do it." "What? I don't have any power." "You can do it. How?" "Do you love your parents?" "Yes." "Parents love you?" "Yes." "You tell your father." "What is India?" "India is only nothing but so many families. In every family, the child tells his or her father, 'Papa, please don't do corruption. I don't want 2 mobile. Whatever little I have got, I am satisfied. I want simple living, but don't do corruption.' Can you do that? If you can tell to your father, particularly it is father who does corruption, you know, more or less. Mother is only taking the fruits of corruption, preparing the list, what are the items we should ask for corruption from under the table. Basically, it is the father. So he says, tell your father, please don't do it. Tell your mom, please don't do it. I want, you are telling me, be truthful. Every day you are telling me, satyam vada dharmam chara. So you follow it, I also want to follow. If you can tell your parents, you love your parents and the parents love you, so for the sake of your love, they will give up corruption. And if all the family members, they give up corruption, the corruption is removed from the country immediately, overnight. That is the only way corruption can be removed. That is what Dr. Salam said. So even small children can contribute. But ultimately, it is the family system. The family values contribute to the national values. So ultimately, we don't have to put on any sort of grumbling on XYZ. Let us start with our own family. Are we practicing values in our family? Then our children will become enlightened citizens. And when they become enlightened citizens, when they become good, the country will be good. So the responsibility of the parents is not only giving the best possible education, but also value education. Swami Vivekananda said, education, education, education alone is the panacea of all our ills. But what type of education? He said, what we want is man-making education, character-building education. So the parents have to understand the importance of value education. Now, I will come to that topic in the second session if there is time permit, how value education can be practiced or can be given in the families. Now, nurturing relationship. You are all parents. So you are nurturing the children. Nurturing the children is like nurturing a plant. So what are the things necessary? First of all, the soil must be good. If you put a plant here, it is not going to grow. You have to make the soil ready. That is number one. So that is what I told, that before the children are born, the mother particularly has to undergo some penance. Out of prayer, that land will be, where best land will come. Then you put the seedling, the plant will grow. But once you put the seedling, best possible seed you give, best possible land also you have tilled, even then, so many other things are required. The first thing that is required is fencing. If you do not have a fencing, the goats and cows will come and eat away the plant, isn't it? So that is why some guarding is necessary. That is why parents are called guardians. You have to guard your children. Particularly when they are children, you have to guard them. You have to guard their culture. You have to guard their character. You have to guard their interest. So a guarding is necessary. But how long? Till the plant has grown. When the plant has become a tree, if you put a guard, the tree will not grow, because it requires fresh air and fresh sunlight. But you want to protect your children and hug like this and don't allow you to grow. That is why they are stifled. One girl told me, my mom loves me so much that I feel suffocated. That is not love, that is attachment. You want your attachment, my girl, I want to be with myself, so I will not allow her to go for higher education to any other city or anywhere. No, I want her to be with myself. How long you will keep that girl? Guarding is necessary to a certain extent, but then remove the guard. But of course, there has to be an indirect watch. Become their friends, but indirect watch. Watching is necessary. Of course, many parents have become intelligent. Now the children, you know, they have, you know, internet chatting, going together and then suffering. Now the parents, they also become Facebook friends under some pseudo name. And they are watching with whom this fellow is cheating, my son. So now the children also become wise. They have left now Facebook. Because ultimately they found out the parents are there, so they will find out with whom we are chatting. So they are going for WhatsApp and other things now. So anyway, so this struggle is going on. From parents want to have a watch, but they must have keep a watch. But from a distance, to become your friends, don't just be like a guard and always try to be suffocating them. They should not feel suffocated. Give them freedom. Freedom, air is freedom, and sunlight is outside. At the same time, protect their interest. So that is second. Then you also require fertilizers. What is fertilizer? Good conduct is a fertilizer. Give that your child a good patting whenever he or she brings some laurels, birthday, something. It is not only gift, but also your words, which will be more soothing. So these sweet words, they will act like fertilizers, manures. But that is also not enough. Sometimes there is weeds are there. What is the weed? That is greed. So when the weeds are there, the plants cannot grow. So you have to remove that greed. Greed will be removed only if your greed is removed. And then there are insects. They eat away the plants. So you have to have pesticide. What are the insects? Jealousy, anger. These eat away the plants, plants of relationship. So you must have pesticide. How? What is the pesticide? P for pesticide, P for prayer. Prayer is the only thing by which you can remove jealousy from the minds of your children and from your own mind, and anger and all those things. Prayer will act as a pesticide. Last but not the least, if you have done all these things, but most important thing for nurturing a plant, what is that? Water. Very true. But water is not enough. You know, as it just now you heard, before coming to Vadodara, I was in Porbandar. On 26 January 2001, there was earthquake. So Ramakrishna Mission takes up any earthquake, any calamity anywhere. Immediately from the day one, we start our relief work without government asking us to do that. And so we started begging money, and we collected 20 crores of rupees, and we constructed 81 school buildings of government in Gujarat and of Gujarat, and handed over to government of Gujarat. And then we constructed 6 colonies, out of which 3 colonies and 37 school buildings were constructed in Porbandar when I was in Porbandar. So these colonies, when we constructed, we wanted we should not give them only houses, but we should give them art of living also. So along with the houses in the colony, we had prayer hall, we had community hall, we had dispensary, we had other amenities, so that they have a nice, excellent, this one. And of course, we wanted the colony to be Nandanvan. We have given them Sanskar Dham, Vivekan Sanskar Dham, Ramakrishna Sanskar Dham, Ma Sharda Sanskar Dham. This is the name we have given. So if they become Sanskar Dham, there has to be a lot of plants. So we planted a lot of trees. Unfortunately, the trees died. We gave a lot of water, and yet the trees died. Why? Because in Porbandar, you get water only from 8 feet below the sea level. But sea is very nearby, so the water is salty. So even if you give plenty of water, the plant will die if it is a salty water. So what type of water we want? Sweet water. So afterwards we brought from, there was a reservoir, we made a check dam, and the rainwater was, there was a little conservation. From there we gave this one. And then with this conserved water, we gave the sweet water, rainwater, and then the plants came up. Now the trees have come up. So the most important thing, Deepak Chopra says in his book on parenting, that the only one word I can say for parenting, if it boils down to one word, it is love, love, and love. But what type of love? Not salty love. Not selfish love. Unselfish love. We are giving love, of course. We are giving water, but it's salty water. The plant will be not nurtured. The plant of relationship, it gets killed by salty slaughter, salty love, selfish love. One gentleman was telling, he was in Anand. He was a police officer. So he came to be the idea, my son, out of control. He wants to get married to a girl who is from other caste, and now my prestige will be all done, gone. Like that he was lamenting. I said, now what is the problem with you? Girl is very bad? No. The family is very bad? No. Only problem is, it is from different caste. So, what people will tell me? So I said, you are not concerned about your son's welfare. You are concerned more about mara nak nu su tha maru nak kapai jase to you tamne nak ni chinta chhe chokra ni chinta nathi. So ultimately, if you really find that both are having true love and both are having good character and everything is matching, what is the problem with you? Mara nak nu su tha se maru nak kapai jase caste. So you are more bothered about your prestige. Then I told, you see, as parent, you have to give unselfish love. Khalil Gibran said, your children are not your children. They are God's children. They have come through you. You have to give them nourishing, and that is all. But don't get so much attached. Attachment is always bad. Love is very nice. There is difference between attachment and love. Attachment and love difference is unselfish love is love, and selfish love is attachment. For my interest, I want that child to be with me. I will not allow him to go to America because I want with him. I want to be want him to be with me. But if you find out that he will be getting better education and he can get more quality education in America, why? So you are a parent. You have to think about not your interest or not your attachment. You have to think really what can be. And if you find out that good will not come to him by going abroad, then of course you put a break. I don't mind. But we have to be very, very introspective. Really, whether it is the interest of the boy or whether it is my prestige. Ultimately, he could understand the message and then he got that marriage done and both are now very happy. Both the parents are happy and those two also are very happy. Now they are becoming parents also. But anyway, what I am saying is that I have given you one example. So while taking any decision, let us see whether... So in relationship, when you want to nurture a plant, the most important thing is love. But not saltish love, not saltish water, not selfish love, unselfish love, not attachment, but real love. If that is there, there will be a beautiful nurturing of the children. Now, to end, I will just give some success mantras of parenting because we are behind schedule a little bit. Easy to remember, A, B, C, D, E, F. I can go up to Z, but we will not go. A, accept. Accept the children as they are. Accept the children as they are. They have come from God. They have come through you, but they are given by God. Whatever gift God has given, you accept them as they are, with all their weaknesses, with all their faults, with all their good or plus or minus points. This is the first thing. If you can accept them wholeheartedly, 50% of your problem of parenting is over. At present, we are struggling. Swami Vivekananda says, if you tell a person you are a donkey 100 times, he will become a donkey. Tu gadhedo cho, gadhedo cho, hajar var kevati, gadhedo thai jase. Words ma power hoy chhe. But if you say, my child, you are given by God, you are divine, you are divine, you are divine, then the child will really become divine. There is a power of words. When Swami Vivekananda went to America, I told yesterday, no? Swami Vivekananda used to say, everybody, Americans, ye, the children of immortal bliss, holy and perfect beings, ye, divinities on the sinners, it is a sin to call man so, it is a standing level on human nature, come up, O lions, and shake up the delusion that you are sheep, your soul is immortal, spirits free, blessed and eternal, you're not matter, you're not bodies, matter is a servant, not ye the servant of matter. And then he used to say, you are divine, you are divine, you are divine. And then one American lady said, Swami, you are trying to hypnotize us, always telling you are divine, you are divine, you are divine. And Swami immediately replied, Madam, I am not trying to hypnotize you, I am trying to de-hypnotize you. Always saying, I am sinner, you have become sinner. You are feeling like sinner. No. You are divine, that is the first truth. You are divine, that is the second truth. You are divine, that is the last truth. Each and every human being has got divinity within. Outwardly, he may be physically handicapped, mentally retarded, whatever. But inside every human being, inside every child, is that divinity. Try to address that divinity. You are divine, you are divine. You are divine, you are divine. Tell your children, you are divine, you are divine. Whatever some small weaknesses have come, forget about it. You are not sinner. You are divine, you are divine, you are divine. Again and again tell. 1,000 times you say, it becomes truth. That is the power of words. So Swami, we can use that power of words. And that is the last truth. Swami says, even if a person has committed thousands of murders, what of that? Inside every human being, even inside that murderer, is that same divine soul. Only there is a covering. The covering has become more thick in terms of in the person, in that person who is murdering. That's all. Remove the covering. Gungat ka pat khol re, tohe piya milenge. Katuk vachana mat bol re, tohe piya milenge. Kabir says, remove that screen. Immediately you will get मुको कहा तू ढूंढे बंदे, मैं तो तेरे पास में, खोजोगे तो अभी मिलूंगा, पल भर की तलाश में. सो इनसाइड इज दैट इज देयर. सो एक्सेप्ट देम एज डिवाइन. मातृदेव भव, पितृदेव भव, आचार्य देव भव, अतिथि देव भव, ऑल्सो बालक देव भव, विद्यार्थी देव भव. आई टेल द टीचर्स, विद्यार्थी देव भव. इनसाइड द चाइल्ड ऑल्सो देर इज गॉड और गॉडेस. Always tell, you are God, you are goddesses. You are God, you are goddess. You are God, you are goddess. In India, we had a very beautiful custom to give the name Saraswati, Durga. Now, if you give that name to a girl, or Dimpy, Pimpy, so many names. I asked that girl, what is the name? I do not know. But no name, absolutely no meaning of that name. Meaningless names, meaningless girls, meaningless names. So previously we had this particular, this any name that will be somehow connected with God, so that immediately remembers, no, I am Shyam, I am Ram, I am Radhika, I am Krishna. That name itself, and father has to take name, you know. You know the story of Bhagavata, Ajamil. Was a sinner, was a drunkard, criminal, all types of sins he had committed. But he had a son named Narayana. So at the time of death, wow, he was very much attached to Narayana. So at the time of death, the last word that he spoke was Narayana, Narayana, and he died. Immediately, all the Vishnus, all these people, they all came to take his soul. And Yamraj also sent his emissaries to take the soul. And there was fight. He said, he was such a criminal, he must go to hell. And you are taking him to heaven, and you are taking him to Devloka, to Brahmaloka. No, no, but in our scripture it is told, if anybody takes the name of Lord at the time of death, he has to go to Lord only. So we are taking him to Lord because he took the name Narayana. But he took the name Narayana for his son. But whatever it is, he took the name Narayana, so he will go to Narayana. So that is the benefit. If your son or daughter's name in God or goddess name, even if you are attached to that boy, if you are not taking name of Lord, by taking the name of your child, you go to God. That is why our, and it is a psychological thing. 10 times, 100 times, every day you have to call Radhika, Radhika, Radhika. Sometimes Radhika may come and give you darshan. A real Radhika may give you darshan. Because your daughter Radhika, you are attached to your Radhika. But Radhika may come. No, he is calling me. Radhika may think that you are calling Radhika. She may come also. Who knows? So this is what we used to keep the names. So ultimately, whether we keep the name or not, nowadays very peculiar names are given. But even names are whatever you give, try to think the divinity within and try to respect that divinity and try to give that love to that divinity. Presently there may be a covering, but once the cover is removed, so accept the children as they are, and second is adjust with them. Yes, these are the failings, whatever it is that. Let there be adjustment. Let there be, after acceptance, let there be adjustment. B is most important. Be and make. Swami Vivekananda gave the golden formula to Sister Nivedita. Be and make. First you become great, then make others great. First you follow the values, then others will follow the values. As I told you, if you do not follow the values, you cannot expect your children to follow the values. Papa kese potana baalak ne ja kahi de papa ghar ma nathi. Bicharo nanak baalak shu kese papa kese papa ghar ma nathi. Are akal na othmir me tane kidu tu ke to papa ghar ma thi pashu aa dod laayo chhe ne ane kahi didu shu ke papa kese papa ghar ma nathi. Lyo. But this is how he is getting the values from the family. Ke how to speak the lie, how to speak the lie. He is telling some children were playing the game, and one person was passing by. Hey, what are you doing? Well, we are playing the game. Whosoever can speak the blackest lie and can give the bluff, biggest bluff, he will get the prize. What? There should not be competition of speaking lie. You should be competition of speaking the truth, not of speaking lie. You see, in my whole life, I never told it, never told a lie. And all the children say, sir, you get the first prize. Because we know you only 5 days back you took a medical certificate without getting you sick. And now you are telling my whole life I have not lied. So you get the first prize. So children know their parents and teachers much more than we know each ourselves. They have got a CID department. I don't know from where they get it. Intelligence department they have got. And so they know all our ins and outs. They are very intelligent. So when we do not practice the values, we can't expect our children to practice the values. So Swamiji said, be and make. Behavior pattern is very important for the parents. As I told you, even that person also had to pay heavily for his dishonesty. So if we are honest, if we are truthful, if we are trying, we are following the values, children will follow. I am giving an interesting real story. In one of our ashramas, one boy used to come. You know, we have youth study circle and values programs. So he was coming. His father was furious. Why? Akai ashrama jawani umar che? Is it an age to go to ashram? After retirement, one should go. You are giving at a young age. And these monks, they do not know. They are most impractical. They will tell you, satyameva jayate, and all these things, they will spoil you. Don't you know? Now the latest mandate in the modern age is asatyameva jayate. The more you can speak the truth, the more you can be dishonest, the more you will earn money. So you have to be practical. You have to be very practical in life, and all these values, these satyameva jayate, etc., they are backdated. In the modern age, if you have to survive, it is an age of competition. You will have to go for dishonesty. You will have to go for untruthfulness. Don't go to these Swamiji, they will spoil you. So he stopped coming to our ashrama. After 1 year, his father came to us. He came to the Swami. Swamiji, bachaiye, kya ho gaya? Arre, bachche ko taap le gaye the. Arre, wohi bachche ka hi baare mein bol raha hu. Bachche ko maine bola tha, hamesha jhoot bolna. Ye aajkal ke zamane mein sach bolne se nahi hoga. Abhi ye honesty, ye truthfulness, ye sab nahi chalega. Usne experiment kiya, mera hi pickpocket karna shuru kar diya. Charity begins at home. So pickpocketing also begins at home. So, बोले अभी वो बोलने आया कि नहीं नहीं आप उसको वैल्यू एजुकेशन की क्लास में डालिए. इट इज मेकिंग टू मच फॉर मी. सो अल्टीमेटली द पेरेंट्स इफ दे फॉलो द वैल्यूज देन ओनली चिल्ड्रन विल फॉलो. सो बी एंड मेक. थर्ड इज कम्युनिकेशन. द ओनली वे वी कैन ब्रिज द गैप ऑफ दिस जनरेशन गैप इज टू हैव मोर एंड मोर कम्युनिकेशन. लेट अस ट्राई टू हैव मोर कम्युनिकेशन. लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड अवर चिल्ड्रन. दे हैव देयर ओन प्रॉब्लम्स. वी हैव अवर ओन प्रॉब्लम्स. चिल्ड्रन हैव देयर ओन प्रॉब्लम्स. Particularly the peer pressure, outside atmosphere is too much. And so for them it is very difficult to follow you or maybe sometimes accede to your request. So you try to find out what is the problem with your child. Sometimes we do not understand. He wants water and we give milk. And then he dies out of thirsty. So we are giving only, we have done our game, we have given him the latest mobile, and now that's all. We have done our duty as a parents. No. More what is required is that, as I told you, love, concern, and what we are trying to give is, we are trying to prove that we are also right, and we are also always right, and they are always wrong. Let us try to have communication. That is more important. D is discipline. In the family, there should be some discipline. There should be a sort of a timetable. Just as in our ashramas, we have a timetable. Morning, 5 o'clock, there is Mangala Arati. Everybody has to come to Mangala Arati, sit down for meditation. Then we have some chanting from Gita and all that. Then we have a breakfast. There is a bell ringing and all then come for breakfast. Again, there is lunch. So there are some particular timetable, some sort of discipline. Now, supposing it is not possible to take meals together in the lunch, at least dinner time, one meal should be there. If you eat together and pray together, most of your misunderstanding will be over. Eating together and praying together, at least one meal together and praying together. Never have a meal without prayer. And at least read 5 minutes before you start your dinner, 5 minutes, some book of positive thoughts. Say the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna, Ramakrishna Kathamrit, or teachings of Swami Vivekananda, or teaching of Buddha, teaching of Mahavir. Small book. Just read out one para and then start your dinner. Because when there are holy vibrations, holy thoughts inside the mind, this food becomes prasad. and when you chant some mantra and then take prasad, then food, that food becomes prasad. Prasad will give you prasad. Prasad means prasannata. That means will give you happiness. But most of the time what we are doing, we are watching TV and watching murder and watching, and after all media means negative news. One of our management experts, he came to our seminar on management. He said, don't read newspapers in the morning. Why? Energy level will go down. They have told, when the negative thoughts, the energy level goes down. Because newspapers are mad, newspapers are sad, newspapers are bad, newspapers make you mad. Sad and bad news will be more there, in media also. And we take food while watching TV, whole family. What happens? Poison, poison, poison is going. Poisonous thoughts are making poison. So there should be some discipline in the family if you really want to give values to the children. And if you want that they should be disciplined, we have to be also disciplined. Let there be some discipline, some sort of 9 o'clock dinner. For example, in our ashrama, we have 9 o'clock dinner. Exactly 9 o'clock, the bell rings. So set timing for prayer. Eating together, praying together will make your family a very holy family, and also a very sweet family. Then EQ, emotional quotient, is very required, both on the side of children and both the side of the parents also. F is forget and forgive. Whatever happened, forget. Jagya tarthi savar, gai gujri bhuli jao. Sometimes there are mistakes, this and that. Now, there may be some misunderstanding also. So I tell them, when there is more of disharmony and always, you know, some families, always members are quarreling with each other. Always quarreling. Now what to do? What is the solution? I give them the solution. Don't quarrel for 7 days. Only 7 days, don't quarrel. Seventh day, you will have a quarreling session. Everybody should keep the diary. Whatever you want to tell, you keep down. All type of allegations, you write down. Don't tell that time. All types of allegations, there will be quarreling session when you will tell, Papa, you did like this, Papa, you did like that. They will say, hey, children, you did like this. There will be, that is a quarreling session. So, but what happens that most of the time it is our emotions. When they do not get vent, ultimately you will see your list is very small. There is nothing to tell. And even if it will be told, when you tell, that intensity will be less. And still you, communication gap will be reduced if you have a quarreling session. And once a week there is a quarreling session, of course, that should be followed by ice cream party. Forget and forgive. And forbearance. Forbearance is very much necessary. There was one prime minister in Japan, Oh Osun, 17th century. And he had a big family of 200 members. And it was told that there was so much of harmony in the family, even the dogs, they would not quarrel. Normally dogs cannot remain without quarreling at night, but even the dogs do not quarrel. Then the emperor was very much impressed. He came to that prime minister who was very old. He said, what? We have got small families, still we cannot keep harmony, and you are keeping harmony in such a big family. You please give me the secret formulas. The success mantras for keeping harmony in the family, you give me 100 formulas and I will circulate these 100 formulas all over the country. Then the prime minister said, Oh Osun said, okay, you bring me a piece of paper. He brought a piece of paper, started writing with pencil, 100 formulas for keeping harmony in the family. What are the mantras? Forbearance, 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 forbearance. 100 times he wrote forbearance. Sahan karo, sahan karo, sahan karo, sahan karo. We have to develop the spirit of forbearance that will give this one. Then giving, unselfish love. H is harmony, I already told you. And then Holy Mother Sarada Devi used to say, all the letters are one. Ka, ka, ga. But one letter comes three times. What is that? Sa, sha, sha. Sahan karo, sahan karo, sahan karo. Forbearance will give harmony and peace in the family. And then introspection. Where are we going? Whether family values, are we adopting, are we sticking to the Indian spiritual values for which is giving us harmony and peace? So once we have that harmony and peace in the family, when the amount of anger and the expression of anger is less in the family by all the members. When there is regularly some time when they pray and eat together, praying together, eating together, in that family there will be peace, there will be harmony. In that family, the children, when they come up, they will come with the values. And then Vivekananda Gandhiji will come up once again into the country. Thank you very much.